Hello everybody, and welcome back to Hyrule Warriors Age of Calamity. We will now be tackling a Hyrule outpost. We've gathered all four guardians, divine beasts, and their pilots. So now, I don't know what we do. I don't know if we start to push back or something. But we're going to see. Did some side quest related things, mostly, you know, powering up Urbosa and unlocking other markets and stuff like that. Well, I did do some more stuff than that.
The four divine beasts were assembled with their pilots. Training began in earnest, and the plan to defeat Hyrule's enemies began to coalesce. Zelda continued her work, calibrating the divine beasts and researching ancient relics. Much to her frustration, however, her sealing power remained dormant.
His Majesty did not offer even a single word of praise.
Well, it's only natural that Father would be frustrated.
But, Your Highness...
Right now, we must do whatever is in our power. Please inform Mipha and Daruk that we depart tomorrow morning.
Then you plan to go to the Divine Beasts? Understood.
That the reason my ability hasn't awakened is because I haven't worked hard enough. I imagine that when I visit the Divine Beasts, he'll say as much. Huh? Oh, Link, you... The adjustments to the Divine Beasts are not yet complete. We must fine-tune them for the individual pilots to ensure that they will be as effective as possible. So many of their parts are complex.
Daruk, I have a request. Might I join you for training next time? I would like to be fully prepared. Learning new ways to fight foes might do me some good.
Of course, the more the merrier. Thing is, we still need a knight gritty enough to seal the darkness, and they're nowhere to be found.
Yes.
Although, hey, if you see anybody that... Huh?
You clan ninjas.
Your Highness, I bring news. It regards your impending death.
It's definitely slowing down a bit here, struggling.
Oh,
Yeah, so I was want so some of the side quests that I was doing, you had to do is Link to unlock combos or further extend his combos for the other weapons that he uses, which is the spear and two-handed weapons. Now I didn't use those weapons, even though I didn't use them for the majority of the game. No reason why, I just didn't. But after using them to do the side quest, it made me think and wonder at the same time, and maybe a little disappointed in the game, in the fact that the previous game, Hyrule Warriors, just Hyrule Warriors, each character had different weapons that they could use. Like Link had his Master Sword or his regular sword and shield. Then he had I'm going the wrong way. He just disappeared. Each character had different weapons. Link had the sword and shield combo. I think he had the flame rod. I think he had like a couple, like maybe two other weapons or something. Cause I know Link had the most weapons because he's Link. And then every other character had like one or two weapons that they could choose from outside of the starting weapon. But this one seems like they all just use one weapon, which, you know, outside of Link, you know. It's either you use the the Rook uses the great bone crusher sword. Urbosa uses the scimitar. What's her name? Mika uses the trident, and Ravali uses the bow. And that's like just the weapons that they use. Now, I get that they made each character play drastically different. You know, Rosa has lightning that she can command. Daruk has the invincible shield, allows him to bowl through enemies. Didn't even press that. Mipha can summon water. And yeah, that's all of them. And then you have Zelda's playstyle, which she uses the Sheikah Slate endlessly, basically. She has no cooldown on it. Then you have Impa, who has the whole ninja like fighting style thing going for her. So it's like they all fight drastically different, but it'd be nice just to have something, you know, else besides just their one weapon. Just to break up the, you know, monotony of the combat. Now, other Dynasty Warrior games broke it up by having, well, unless they were like, unlike Fire Emblem Warriors, or whatever it was called, Fire Emblem had a system that was, unique due to the Fire Emblem's core gameplay mechanics, where you have axes beating, like, spears, and swords beating axes, and spears beating swords, and, you know, they, you know, stuff like that. If you're familiar with the, the Fire Emblem series, then you know what I'm talking about. So it had that. What the hell? You were supposed to die from that. How did he survive? Whatever. Oh, did I go the other way? You know, so that had like a bit of strategy to it. So you had to pick and choose who you sent with you to combat the enemies. You know, that game was like, oh no, you choose the wrong archetype. You know, you choose swords and you're fighting against a bunch of spears. You know, you're gonna have a bad time. You know, so that's how that game broke up its monotony. Plus, it had dragon riders, Pegasus riders, magic users and such, you know. This guy not a... Okay, well, geez, he wasn't that important, but you know, he locked all the wind rules out here. Excuse me. Well, yeah, so... Then you got the regular Dynasty Warriors games, which just have a slew of characters who also have different fighting styles, even though they may use spears or swords or other similar weapons, they play different. You know, so it's like you might have several spear users, but one might have fire attunement, and another one might have wind attunement, and they use different abilities based off, use different fighting styles based off of that. And depending, like if it's the Orochi series of Dynasty Warriors, you literally get monsters and like, you know, crazy, you know, like yokai to fight as. So that even breaks up the, the casualness of it? The repetitiveness of it. There we go. I said casualness. The repetitiveness of it. So. So, it's like, I think, since they have such a small cast of characters to work with, they should have fleshed them out some more with just different weapons. you know. Ow. Or something.
I'll freeze you out.
Oh, well, I think you can do that move. I mean, it'll work out for me.
Sure.
Yeah, it did work out for me. Electric mobbins. You take one side, I'll take the other side. But yeah, I mean, I guess that's like just one minor gripe. And it's not so much a gripe for me, but it's like so much like if people watching can get tired of seeing the same thing over and over again. You can head on up and take care of that, can't you?
Witness, freeze.
I need some help. Lightning one? So what one lies and waits here? And the question would be, would it be faster to go through the outpost? And capture or just go around? I'm going to get out just because I'm going to kill stuff. I'm going to die. I'm going to fake it. Oh shoot. I'm setting myself on fire. Was a quick capture. Now we just go this way. And deal with, I guess it'd be a fire moblin. The other one was ice and lightning. So I can only assume that this would be a fire moblin. Or not. Oh, and the violin's over here. Oh. You know what's that's messed up? Oh damn, hit me. Is Oh, these are actually different. Yeah, isn't strange that she can't like activate like their Like, if I use a rod and hit him with lightning or any of the other elements, they'll instantly go into, like, a breakable state. But when she does it, they don't go into a breakable state. Alright, I'm gonna charge up just before I head up to the top real quick. Yeah, let's go. I'm gonna blow that down. I saw you off your distance. Trying your bull. Ooh. Oh, and I got it. Maybe I can take down a tower at the same time with this. Yes, I can. Like, I don't really like complaining about things and not having solutions for them. So, if I had to give the characters additional weapons, I'll start with Impa because she's like the first one you get. And, she'd be easy, you know. Even though her fighting style less so consists of the weapons she uses and, like, her ninja arts, and she like does a whole bunch of like talisman magic and just, you know, a whole lot of stuff. She does a lot of things, so it would be hard to come up with her in reality, because she doesn't just like use her sword. She like throws explosive kunai, uses magic talismans. So I'm actually trying hard to come up with something for her. I think we gotta go around. Gotta go around. That is lame. But I guess she could focus more on the ninja arts. Using, like, because right now she only uses really, like, wind. And everything else, she just kind of uses explosives for her. So you could make it so she uses, like, fire, ice, and electric. And combines them in various ways. So she could have more ninja art style abilities. I guess the talismans would be a medium range fighting style, and then you have a long range fighting style that would circle around throwing weapons, kunai, shuriken, and things of that nature. And they could just be like a wide coverage, kind of like Varali's arrows. like he... Ooh, snap. What the hell happened? I probably had, like, explosive arrows. Like, bomb arrows, basically. You know, so you combine that with faster, more widespread shurikens and kunai. And you can come up with something for that. For Rally, I feel like he could use daggers. Since he's a very fast, agile character. Just have him zip around and do like diving attacks. And swooping, where like he takes flight and just like dive bombs past the enemy, cutting them up. If I had to think of a third weapon for him. Wrong way. Let's see, what do we think for Rally? Well, you got a kicking thing, you know, where he kicks you. Because, I mean, he is a bird. And, he's got those talons on his feet. So it wouldn't be too unrealistic to think of him wearing, like sharpened talons on his feet to fight with. So he could always fight with his feet. You know, he can do like, cause he has like grab attacks in his one fighting, in his current thing. So it's not like he couldn't grab his opponents and like slam them and toss them into the other enemies. You know, stuff like that. He has his whole rolling ball thing, but he could probably get more elaborate weapons, a hammer, but the hammer won't really be like so much of has his strength, but has his ability to manipulate the earth and like cause the earth rocks and boulders that he summons to become magma and explode them. But he kind of does that now, but not that much. Stop. So I have to focus around his, like him summoning rocks, turning them into, filling them with magma, and then having them explode, setting them on fire. She can have one based around her abilities to manipulate water, so she could just be like drowning the enemies basically in floods of water, and then using it to teleport around and get around the battlefield. Oh, Okay, I could use the thing of help. Oh, excuse me. Give her some more, oh man, she's standing on the eye and electrocuted her. Did I kill her? Can't see his health bar. Oh, can I have another weakness point slash on it? Yep. Yeah. He's dead now. But yeah, you can give Mipha ability to control water better. Now we gotta save Zelda. And they made me leap. Which is fine. Where am I at? Yeah, so, yeah, Mipha got a better control of water, but, ooh, what the hell? His next thing, her next thing, sorry. Yeah, start ripping me, yo. Oh, what the hell? Something just flew in my eye. Oh no. As long as I ain't a problem, we can find. Now it's time to beat him with this. Oh, never mind. I'm just gonna do a mega slash on him. Not enough to kill him. This dude is very sturdy. I would be utterly not surprised. What else could you give me from? Ooh, it's bad. Oh, I dodged this. Ooh.
I suppose destiny is at work then. The future is fickle. Yiga clan, time to go.
Hey man, that was mine. That was me. That was mine. I was to block that. You stole my shine. He's like, well, I'm sorry, I was just reacting. I'm the hero of Tom here, alright? I'm the one who's gonna win. He's like, ain't this your king? Why don't you deal with it? He's still going off on him. No, did she finally get a different weapon? Oh my god. Okay. Finally a different looking weapon. Ah, finally, this thing I needed. Got two recipes. Well, we got a lot of side quest stuff to do. And he wants me to start with this, which is Impa's training. Okay. Well, we won't be doing that, at least not on screen. But thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope you have a nice day. And I'll see you all in the next video.